So, I'm back. I have a few clips that I've tried to explain where I've been and why. Stuff has happened since then. Like, obviously I lost my job, still unemployed, that's great fun. But I also got dropped by BSN from Thursday gone, so it's Monday. So Thursday just gone a few days ago, and I got dropped by BSN. And I was now doing it on my own. I very much was very much a fan of BSM. I very much enjoyed being on the team, but simply because I'm not in the city. They have a guy and a girl in Dublin, they have a guy in the north, and they want a guy in Cork, and basically they couldn't afford all them athletes, so it was goodbye to me. So geographically it didn't make sense, therefore I just got the boot, really. Didn't play down to who was more socially active, or because, no offense to anyone else, but I feel like I was the only one socially active. Like, a few people that I said that to didn't actually realise that there was other Irish athletes. Thought I was the only one. But anyway, we won't get into that, that's bullshit. What's for you won't pass you. And all that other fucking quote of the day, QOTD, sod. Because I've been unemployed for Christmas, I'm going back to points with PT, but I have to wait until they square a few things off. Probably until then, I've been unemployed since 2 weeks before Christmas. Actually, I had no money, so I just thought there has to be some people out there that are in the same situation as me, that are looking to grow, and they're looking to gain some muscle or weight. My approach to food has changed an awful lot as my circumstances have changed, so I just thought that if I showed you what I do, like, for example, breakfast, I'm only going to be able to eat what's here because I can't go out and buy breakfast. I can't actually go out and buy groceries for breakfast because I literally can't afford it. So, I have no carbs for breakfast because it basically, in a nutshell, makes you a little bit more insulin sensitive throughout the day. So, I will save my carbs for during training and after training. So, when I do that, my body responds better to carbs because my insulin's not being shot up every meal and then crashing and then coming back down. So if I hit carbs for breakfast now, my insulin would spike, eventually it would drip back down, and it would just happen. If people eat 6 meals a day, it just keeps spiking and dropping and spiking and dropping. Whereas I just let it level out, stay at a particular range until I need it to, which is basically during and after training when you want to build muscle, spike it up and then slowly range it down. So I have 4 eggs, roughly just under 30 grams of protein, and just over 20 grams of fat in that. So fat wise, I'm gonna put 10 grams of coconut oil in this bish before I scramble these eggs. 20-30 grams of fat is grand, but then that's not enough protein. Like, 30 grams of protein isn't enough for the biz. I might throw a few egg whites on as well, or have 2 scoops of whey. So if I have 2 scoops of whey, it'd be pretty easy, because to be honest with you, I'm sick of the taste of eggs. Basically, 4 eggs, a black coffee, and 2 scoops of whey. So that, and then max effort lower with the great white coach. Right, making my intro. Have another scoop of coffee. I usually don't drink that much coffee so close together, but just thought it worked out today. 10 grams of BCAAs, 100 grams of carbs from dextrose. I got that wrong. 50 grams of carbs, still 10 grams. With a little ghetto funnel for my little bro jug.
Half the wrap, right?
I'll go up overly.
Now cover half the wrap again when they go round. So just go round and cover half here.
Bag of jellies. Oh, the old Garland over there being all gay with.
No, that's what it is. It's very, very colourful. That's all you need in your life right there. Look at that. No Cocoa Pops, what you do?
Hard to five a day. So, literally just got back there, dropped Dean back to Boyneside. And we were going out to a friend of ours because he was doing some camera work for us because we were going to start recording a podcast that I would be on. Did a 195 for three squat, and then I did a 210 deadlift for three, and then just a little bit of abs. Was fucked after it. That's what was happening today for most of the day. Another funny thing though, before I go anywhere, is ever since I've been dropped by from BSN, it seems to be a one big question I've been asked lately. Like, besides all the support I've been getting from people, which is great, but a lot of people have been asking me advice on how to get sponsored. And surely I'm the last person you would ask because I've been dropped by a supplement company. Even though the reasons weren't for, it wasn't on my part where I was a bad athlete or I didn't hold at my end of the deal. I think I was a very good athlete and I promoted a brand very well, and I was the best that was there at the time. Now, I could be a lot better, and I know that. I'm not saying it was the best thing since sliced bread, but surely I'm not the fucker to be asking, given the circumstance. I've always tossed this around my head where I don't know if I should say, like, if anyone wants me to talk about a particular topic, just ask, or, like, comment it on, like, I'll post this on Instagram, like, a link for this on Instagram, and post for this on Facebook, or comment it on a YouTube, on the video on YouTube. But, like, put it somewhere for me to see. Talk. I'll do a video talking on whatever, whether it's post-workout nutrition or just normal nutrition or how to get sponsored or what I think is the best way to sponsor. And it's things I've answered for people personally. But if it's a thing that you want me to do a video about, like, because obviously the last while, one thing I struggled with mostly was having something to actually video. Help me to help you. That's it. Get up slowly. What's happening? I have to say hello to my channel, dickhead. Yeah, that's right.
Oh, I got a big fan. I used to be on camera.
Oh, no! You've never been on YouTube before, have you?
No. Unfortunately.